Hello, welcome to the allotment this morning. It's a nice kind of hazy morning and it's nice and, well, coolish this morning. Lovely. I don't do well in the heat. I'm a ginger. I can't cope with it. I hope you've all been enjoying all the heat and I hope it's making all your veg grow over the past couple of weeks. It has been roasting. Anyway, I've come up here first thing, as I have been doing lately, to avoid the heat of the day, because our allotments are very exposed. You kind of get any shade anyway. And I'm going to just be pottering on, showing you a few things, showing you how many things are grown and getting a few little jobs done. So this is the tomato bed and I'm going to try and tackle the tomatoes today. We have been keeping an eye on them. We've been trying to nip out the side shoots and today I want to stake them because they're getting quite tall now and I'm going to try and take off some of the lower leaves. And if you've been watching our previous videos, you'll know I got all my tomato varieties completely mixed up in the greenhouse, which was very unwise. So here they are. They're just a whole mass of tomatoes. Can't even remember what they're supposed to be. I think I've got Moneymaker and I've got Gardener's Delight in there. I do know that. But as for the other varieties, I can't even remember what they are. Anyway, they're all grown beautifully. They are quite close together as usual for me, so I'm going to try and thin them out a little bit. Not thin the plants, but take up the lower growth of the tomatoes. Now, I'm certainly no tomato expert, but I do know from previous years that they're prone to getting fungus and mould later on in the season, so I'm just trying to forestall that and we'll stake them up and see how we get on. So, I'll get these nasturtiums out. Nasturtiums are running rampant in the garden. And I'm just going to cut off these lower ones. Like that. Get rid of them. It helps the airflow. It stops this fungus or blight or whatever you want to call it getting in. Keeps them off the ground. Hope I'm doing it right. So, there we go. Can you see that? Let's just check. I'm not sure how clear that'll be, but I've taken off all the leaves right up to the first truss. Well, they're just flowers at the minute. There's a little tomato starting there, but I've taken off all the leaves below that. And I'm just going to go through and see if I can see any side shoots. But you've got to look carefully, like, because you can think there's none and you come back the next day and there's one 2 foot long. Anyway, I don't see any. And then I'm going to tie it up.
Thank you.
poppies are right in the middle of the border. We just left them in because the poppies are so pretty, and I was going to just pull them out straight away, because now you've got all these lovely poppy heads. We do want to save some of the seeds. I'm also thinking I'm sure I can use poppy seeds. I'm sure they're just standard, and I could use them in my bread and stuff when I make bread. Anybody know anything about that? Are these just ordinary field poppies okay to you to are they edible? I don't want to end up high on opium or something like that if I eat them. I know that won't really happen. I don't think so. Anyway, so I'm still leaving these for these seed heads to ripen a bit. I mean, I could probably just cut them off and let them ripen on the sideboard or something, but I don't think they're interfering too much with the tomatoes at the minute, and they won't be here for much longer. But I've got to climb in right behind them to get to this tomato down here. Whew. That feels like quite an achievement to get all that done, and the tomatoes look nice and tidy now and a lot more spacious and aerated. One issue I am having is I'm absolutely overrun with nasturtiums, which is fine and I love it. Trouble is I find I haven't got the heart to pull them out. I am pulling them out, like, because I've got so many, and everywhere I go, if you take your eyes off it for a couple of days or a couple of weeks or whatever, suddenly find everything's got nasturtiums trailing up. I actually pulled out a full sack, massive bin bag full of nasturtiums the other day that were just encroaching on all the veg. And literally Kenny came up after I'd done it, and he literally couldn't even tell I'd pulled anything out. That's how many there is. Anyway, the hens enjoyed the nasturtiums, and I think they'll be getting quite a few more. Look at all that I've pulled out. So, the tomatoes have had a good haircut. Excellent. So I think one of the reasons that I have had so many nasturtiums, I mean, we had a lot last year, so a lot of them have just dropped the seed where they grew. But I think one of the reasons I'm having so many as well is because I don't think my compost has gotten hot enough when it's been decomposed. Because although I'm really happy that I've been able to produce so much compost last year, and I'm using it loads, it's very fertile, it's great. But there's loads of seeds coming up. Flower seeds, loads of tomatoes, funnily enough, coming up. I must have put tomatoes in there last year. So I think that's why my compost isn't heating up enough. Not exactly sure how to rectify that, because I feel like it should be good. I feel like it should be hot enough. Anyway, we'll try again this next year, maybe to heat up this year. Well, I think the day has come at last. I'm going to start harvesting my peas. I've been waiting and waiting. I've had the odd pod off, which of course are delicious. But I didn't want to pick them too soon, because sometimes even when the pods look quite full, when you actually open them, the peas are still aren't fully formed. Anyway, I've noticed further along there are some that have gone too far. So I'm going to start picking, which is a very happy day for me because I love peas. Fresh homegrown peas anyway. I'm just going to pick them bit by bit and freeze them as I go. Let's just test this one, shall we? Why? That's ready. I'll show you. Don't know whether I'm in shot there or not. Maybe I get to eat them. I've opened them. Yummy. Well, goodness me, it's an awful lot more peas here than I expected there to be. I thought I was only going to be harvesting a few to start off with, but when I've started looking, there are loads. I think the thing is, I've got a few different pea varieties in here, and certainly some of the dwarf peas that I had in were well ready, probably more than ready, to be told, truth be told. Anyway, happy with that. Right then, last task of the day before I head home, probably to get some lunch, I think it must be about lunchtime by now, is to check the courgettes. The courgettes are definitely in. We've been getting two or three a day. Actually, I've been managing to keep up. I've used them all up to now. Yesterday, I've got sorrel, and I made courgette and sorrel soup. We haven't had it yet. I'm probably going to have that for lunch today. So let's have a look through here and see what we've got today. There we go. That one needs picking today. I'm hoping I've only got one today. Courgette, it's the only thing that you hope you don't get too much of, isn't it? Anyway, we'll pick that. It's a beauty. Yeah, I think I've only got that one to pick today. Plenty more coming though. I've intended to grow my courgettes, stake them upright, but actually, well, we'll see how it goes. I don't really see how I can do that because all the stems are just splaying out to the sides. I came through the other day and I cut off all the low down stems, anything below the fruits, which has made everything seem a lot more spacious. And I'm delighted if anybody saw the video where I thought my courgettes were dying. They were tiny little ill-looking plants, and I pushed them in the ground with a bit of blood, fish and bone, and now, well, they're positively resplendent. Oh, on closer inspection, there is one that's got to come out. Isn't it funny how they hide the courgettes? You take your eye off them for a minute. And them arrows. Anyway, that's a nice size. Two today. Right, it's definitely heating up now. So I'm gonna head off home. Can we see my lovely sunflowers? They're all starting to, oh, that one's actually nearly finished already. All starting to come out now. I love the sunflowers. They're such happy, happy flowers. And that's my lovely haul for the day. Love it. Anyway, thank you for joining me. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, think about giving us a thumbs up or subscribe if you haven't already. And we will catch you on the next one. Bye.